Hello friends, in our previous lecture we have completed chapter number 1. Now today we are starting a new chapter in accounting, that is depreciation accounts, chapter number 2. Now friends, in our vocabularies or in our terminologies of part 1, we have seen this concept of depreciation and we have some knowledge about some depreciation. So if you all are remembering, depreciation is an expense of the business. Every year the value of asset is decreasing and that decreased amount is called depreciation. Now in this chapter we will learn in detail about depreciation, how it is calculated, what are the different methods for calculating, how to write a journal entry for depreciation and how to prepare its ledger accounts and how to show in final accounts. So all these things we are learning in this chapter in detail. Now first of all, again we shall discuss that why we need to calculate depreciation on assets. Now friends, suppose if you are having a machinery in your factory. Now that machinery is useful for more than 1 year. So it is treated as your asset. Because as per the rules, what does an asset means? Asset is such a thing which is of ownership of business, and which is useful for more than 1 year. So it is our asset and it is also our capital expense because it is for more than 1 year. Why it requires depreciation? Because in first year we have purchased that for suppose 100 rupees. So that 100 rupees is spent in first year, but the benefit of that 100 rupees is receivable for us in many years. So every year we will decrease the amount because for first year benefit is received, that amount is decreased. Again for second year, again for third year. Doing that way, if it is useful for 7 years, then at the end of 7 years its value will come zero, and which will show that the depreciation is written off within all the years. So it is an expense of all the years. Suppose 70 rupees or 100 rupees we are incurring for 5 years, then every year 2020 we are dividing so that our profit will not decrease due to that and it will become our asset. Okay, that is the reason for showing the depreciation. Or else in other way, we are using the asset. Okay, we are using the asset, its value is decreasing. Now if we are not decreasing the value in our books, then what will happen? Suppose if you are purchasing machinery for 1000, after 5 years you cannot get 1000 from it, its value will be decreasing. So if we are decreasing its value every year, then we will not get a loss, because suppose 1000 is the amount, every year 200 is decreasing, then at the end of 5th year its value will be 200. Then if it is sold for rupees 180, then loss will be only 20 rupees. But suppose if you are keeping only 1000, at the end of you are only keeping 1000, you are not charging depreciation, and at the end if it is sold for 180 rupees, then 1000 minus 180, your loss will be so much. So better to write off depreciation every year. So this is the normal concept of this chapter. Now we are seeing what is given in this chapter. Okay, now introduction. Different kind of tangible assets like machines, furniture, building, vehicles, computer, etc. are used in trade business. Each asset has its own useful life. The useful life is based on time period for which it can be used. Due to the use of assets, its efficiency decreases. Due to natural or physical factors, due to passing of time or due to innovation, the value of assets keep on decreasing. Sometimes, in spite of having good physical condition, the use of old assets becomes expensive due to the emergence of new or more efficient assets. Due to these reasons, the life of asset becomes finite or limited. Because of any of the above stated reason, when the efficiency of asset constantly decreases and consequently the useful life also constantly and permanently decreases, it is known as a depreciation. So they are giving very good introduction. Or in short, first definition is very good. Two definitions are given by Carter and Spicer and Pedler. Carter is giving good definition. Depreciation is the gradual or permanent decrease in the value of an asset due to reason. and Spicer and Mettler are also giving, depreciation may be defined as the measure of exhaustion of the life of asset due to any period. You can write any of the definition, but you tick mark Carter's definition. That is very good. Now, what are the characteristics of depreciation? It is calculated on only fixed assets. So, you cannot calculate on current assets which are for less than 1 year. Its useful life. Depreciation indicates continuous and permanent reduction in useful life of assets and time. Depreciation is time-related expense. Why it is time-related expense? Because at the fixed of every period we are calculating depreciation. Then revenue expense. There are two types of expense. Capital expense which is for more than 1 year and revenue expense which is for less than 1 year. As non-cash revenue expense, depreciation is debited to profit and loss account. They are explaining about final accounts which we will do. Okay, when this concept will come, I will explain. Return of amount. In spite of being revenue expenditure, depreciation is not paid in cash like salary and rent. See, depreciation, you have to know this expense is a non-cash expense. This is an expense of the business, but we are not paying this expense like we are paying salary or rent. At the end of accounting year, generally the amount of depreciation is deducted from the value of assets underlined at the end of accounting year. Provision. Depreciation is one kind of provision. Now, what do you mean by provision or what do you mean by reserves? It will come in the next chapter, so I will explain at that time. Objectives are not required. Now, factors affecting depreciation. Which are the factors? One is useful life. Accordingly, suppose if a machine is used daily 8 hours and if other machine is used daily 6 hours, then the machine which is used more, its depreciation will be more, and machine which will be used less, its depreciation will also be less. Then time factor. How much time or how many years you are using that assets, that is also important while calculating the amount of depreciation. Gradual reduction in quantity. When we are using this machine, indirectly or directly, its quantity will be decreasing. Why its quantity decreasing? Because when the machine was new, you can produce so much of thing. But when the machine is old, now it is not producing that much thing comparing previous. Permanent reduction in market value. As I said, if today you are purchasing an asset, suppose a machine, its value after 2 or 3 years will be so much less. Accident. Sometimes accident is taking place, then we have to replace the asset. At that time also we have to calculate the depreciation. New innovation and research. Other factor for calculation depreciation is technology. Daily new and new technology is coming, so not daily, but we have to change or replace our machine as soon as possible, because if we are not going with the technology, then its value will be equal to zero or near to zero. Why? Think about 2G mobile phones which were before two or three years. Its today's value is nothing. Okay, if you are having a value of 60,000 mobile which was costing 60,000 previous 2 years, its today's values will be 10 or 20,000. Why? Because technology daily is changing. Nowadays 5G technology is latest technology. So your 2G technology mobile will not work. Same thing they are also explaining. Then natural factors. Their depreciation is affecting by natural factors also, like flood, earthquake. Okay, factors to be considered to determine the amount and rate of depreciation. For that, all the things we are not seeing, we are seeing only one thing. See, your cost price is given. How to calculate the cost price of asset? Purchase price plus transportation cost plus installation cost. In short, if I am telling that depreciation, first we need cost price, and cost price is the sum of purchase price and all the expense. Other all things are not required. Then on page number 29, a list is given in the below. Depreciable asset, which assets are depreciable or on which assets we can calculate depreciation. With above observation of mentioned characteristics, list of depreciable assets are as follows: building, plant and machines, furniture fixtures, loose tools. Loose tools means this pana pakad we say loose tools. Leasehold properties, that I will explain when the chapter is coming, fifth chapter. Vehicles, patent, trademark, copyright, mines, gas wells, oil wells, etc. Most of these points I will explain in the fifth chapter, because all these are the concepts of fifth. next chapter, but just now you remember which are the assets on which we can calculate depreciation. The list is given, only that we can calculate depreciation. Other assets we cannot calculate depreciation. Okay, on page number 30, different methods are given. A list is given for different methods of depreciation. Total there are 10 methods, but in our course only first two methods are there. Note is also given. As per our syllabus, practical problems are for fixed installment or straight line method and reducing balance method. All the methods are for a name only. Now in that only they are explaining fixed installment or straight line method. Today we are taking that thing. This is very simple and widely used method. Under this method, the annual amount of depreciation remains identical. Underline, every year the amount of depreciation is same. The graph of depreciation each remains horizontal because every year the same value is calculated. Thus, this method is fixed installment or straight line method. Procedure to determine the amount of depreciation. A formula is given. How to calculate depreciation? Depreciation D is equals to C, cost price, minus S, scrap value, divided by number of years. Okay, then how to calculate the rate of depreciation is also given. D is equals to C, cost price, into R, rate of depreciation, divided by 100. If a rate is given, if they are telling to calculate through percentage, if percentage is given, then depreciation is equals to cost price into percentage. And rate can be calculated in the next page. They are giving R is equals to D by C upon 100 into 100. Now, what are the benefits for using this straight line method? It is very simple method to compute depreciation. This method is easy to understand. Since the amount of depreciation remains identical, no computation is required. What are the disadvantages? Under this method, the amount of depreciation is same every year. Thus, no appropriate balance is maintained between depreciation and maintenance expense. In the initial years, a new asset, the repairing expense comes minimum, and in next year it increases. See, this is very good point. If the depreciation we are keeping same every year, then what is the main disadvantage is that in initial years, means starting years, maintenance cost will be less because our asset is new. Maintenance cost will be less because our asset is new. So much depreciation is not required. And in the forthcoming years, means in the end of years, depreciation will increase. Depreciation have to increase because its maintenance will be increased. Jetli vastu juni thai etlo ena upar depreciation vadhu lage e keva mange chu. Okay? For which assets it is appropriate? This method is appropriate for those assets whose useful estimated life can be determined easily. For example, leasehold properties, copyright, patent, trademark. So this method is useful for such assets whose useful life we can assume. For other assets we cannot assume, like machinery or plant, we cannot assume that useful life. Now, how to write the journal entries for first year and for next year? Okay, they are giving the entry. When the asset is purchased, whenever we are purchasing the asset, this journal entry we know that asset account will be debited including expense. If you are purchasing a machinery and you are incurring the expense, then expenses are not to be shown differently. Expenses are added to asset. So asset account debit to bank account to cash account. For bank account purchase price and bank cash account you show the expenses. Then recording of depreciation at the end of year. How to record the depreciation at the end of year? Depreciation is our expense, so depreciation is debited and machinery is or asset is credited. Then depreciation is closed and transferred to profit and loss account. The depreciation account is the expense and it is closed. It is closed and transferred to which account? Profit and loss account. Because we are preparing profit and loss account for knowing our profit or loss and we are transferring this expense there, so entry will be profit and loss account debit to depreciation account. Why? First depreciation is debited, now we are closing depreciation and transferring, so depreciation is credited. And in second year onwards, only second and third entry will be passed. See, you can see depreciation to asset and profit and loss to depreciation, because we are purchasing the asset only one time, but its depreciation is calculated every time. Now one more entry is not given here for sale of machinery or sale of asset. The entry will be reversed, bank or cash account debit to asset account. Okay, cash or bank account debit to asset account. So this was about the first method. Now we are writing rule. rules for it, but some we will solve it tomorrow. Okay.
So friends, write the name of chapter. Chapter number 2. Depreciation accounts.
The things which we have discussed now, we are writing.
Methods to determine depreciation. Methods to determine depreciation. Okay. In that, the methods which we are using only, I will write fixed installment method or straight line method. Fixed installment method, or its next name is straight line method. Second method is reducing balance method or diminishing balance method.
So these are the two methods which we will use in this chapter.
After that, format or specimen of journal entries.
Specimen of journal entries. Which are the entries that are required to be passed?
Number 1. Not number 1. First we give the link for first year.
For first year,
in that, number 1, purchasing an asset. In the first year, as you know, first asset is to be purchased. At that time, asset is coming in. So, asset account debit to bank account to cash account. In bank account, we will write purchase price, and in cash account, we will write expenses. Because expenses we are paying in cash, and the value of asset we are paying for in check or through bank. Number 2, for charging depreciation at end of year. Normally an year ends on 31st March. So entry for charging depreciation is depreciation account debit, because it is our expense, to asset account.
Number 3, for closing depreciation account.
Profit and loss account debit to depreciation account.
So this is for first year.
For next year's
directly we will start for charging depreciation, because now purchase is not to be made.
For charging depreciation, entry will be depreciation account debit to asset account. Number 2, for transferring depreciation, sorry, not transfer, closing depreciation. For closing depreciation account. Profit and loss account debit. To depreciation account. Then next, I am not writing number 3. I am writing if an asset is to be sold, then what should be the entry? Opposite of this. But here expenses will not be there. So bank account debit. Then loss on sale of asset account debit to asset account to profit on sale of asset account. Now make stars here, because when an asset is sold, if we are getting loss, then loss is debit. If we are getting profit, then profit is credit. Okay, so these are the maximum entries for first year, for purchasing the asset, charging depreciation and closing depreciation. For next all the years, charging depreciation, closing depreciation account, and if asset is sold, then this is the entry. Okay, now we are writing about fixed installment method or straight line method. Okay, in book first journal entries are not given, first explanation is given and then journal entries are given. But I may like to clear that these journal entries are same for second method and first method. In book what they are doing? In book first they are explaining this method, then they are explaining the journal entries, and then sums are given and then second method is given. But I would like to clear that for these two methods, journal entries are same. Only the amount of depreciation will change as per this method. Okay. So this is the common thing about both methods. Now we are again giving the heading fixed installment method or straight line method. Okay. So now we are writing about the first method. Again give number 1. Fixed installment method or straight line method. Fixed installment method or straight line method. In that, formula for finding depreciation. Formulas for finding depreciation. Number 1. There are two ways to find the depreciation. First is when scrap value and number of years are given. When scrap value and number of years are given, depreciation B is equals to cost price C minus scrap value S divided by number of years. Second method, second formula, when percentage of depreciation is given. When percentage of depreciation, instead of scrap value and number of years, when percentage of depreciation is given, then depreciation B is equals to cost price C into rate of depreciation in percentage. Why I am not writing divide by 100? The reason is that in nowadays we are using calculator. So if 10% of 1000 is to be taken, then we will do in calculator simply 1000 into 10 and percentage. We are not doing divide by 100. Okay, so divide by 100 is not required. Then formula for finding rate of depreciation. If this question is asked, then only, otherwise it is not required. Formula for finding rate of depreciation. Then rate of depreciation D is equals to amount of depreciation in rupees divided by cost price C into 100. Then you will get the amount in percentage. Okay. So these are the formulas for finding out the depreciation using fixed installment method. Journal entries we have seen. Now how to prepare the ledger accounts? Then it is as per the journal entry. Okay. So when we are doing it tomorrow, we will know it. So friends, these were all the explanations. Write this thing properly, and tomorrow onwards we will start the first sum. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.